Hi, it's Dr. Rowe. I hope you're well. Talking to you about investing in property with Dr. Rowe, and I am in a renovation property. So whilst I'm here, I'm doing a few short videos addressing some questions that have come in on my piece of paper here, a list of questions that are actually coming in from people asking. And I kind of gone for a pick of the month this month, and that is social housing. So as I'm sitting here now, and this area around me here is an area where actually there isn't necessarily a massive demand for social housing, but within probably 15 to 20 minutes from here, we're going into areas where there is social housing. Certainly 25 to 30 minutes from here, there's definitely social housing. What is social housing? Social housing is essentially housing that's provided for people that are on a low income or potentially no income. And so they get government support, their Department of Social Security. They could be families that have had challenges, financial challenges. It could be people that are single parents, all sorts of different backgrounds. And inside of that group, there is a massive spread on the demographic. Now, why is that important to you as a landlord? Well, I've been doing social housing now since 2001. So that's roughly 18, 19 years. And I've found it to be a very successful model. A lot of people go, oh my gosh, social housing. Do I really want to get into social housing? What about the tenants? What about the damage to the property? These are actually good people who want a home for themselves, and they don't necessarily have the financial situation right now to be able to buy their own property. They may not even be in a position to physically be able to afford to rent their own property. So the government are saying, well, we'll give you some support here. Looking at your circumstances, maybe you're a single mum or a single dad and you've lost your job or something's happened to you on a health perspective. We want to help you out. Your objective is to provide good quality homes to people so that they can take those properties, live in them, and everybody wins. They win because they actually physically get a home. You win because you get some rental income coming in and you get your passive income from it. Now, if you want to simplify this, and you might want to write this down, there's three things to be aware of, really, or three strategies that basically you should be aware of. The first one is where you deal directly with the tenant, and that's where the social housing tenant has been approved for social housing, and essentially what happens is they receive the rent directly from the council or the social housing department. That money comes to them. Now, when I've done this in the past, previously we could get paid through the letting agent. That changed some years ago. The challenge you've got for some people is, well, what if they don't pay me? What if they get into financial difficulties that particular month and they are not in a position to actually pay me? I'm not going to get my rent. And absolutely, that is the challenge. So you've got to be aware of that, which is why the qualifications, the filtering, the checking of the tenants is so important. We'll come to that in just a moment. So if you think of it as an income pyramid, the base of that pyramid would be you're dealing directly with a tenant. And this is why it's important to be aware that there's even a lag, for example, on social housing. Once they move into the property, it might be 6 weeks before they actually receive their rent to pay you. So you've got to allow for that in your cash flow forecasting. Second type of social housing tenancy agreement would be a fixed term tenancy agreement where you get a guaranteed rent for 3, 4, 5, 6 years, 7 years, in some cases up to 10 years, but typically 3 to 5 years. That is paid through a letting agent that's got a link or association with the local housing association. Their rent comes to the letting agent who manages the tenant for you and just works with the local housing association. But you basically are not getting the full rent now. You're getting full rent minus a 10% management fee. And you might say, well, why do I need to do that? Because it's a long-term let. But it might be that they've set that long-term let up for you. They've found it, they've secured it. And as a result of that, they're going to get a kickback from that on a monthly basis, a commission. Well, the benefit to you, of course, in this situation is that you get a guaranteed no voids rent for 5 years or for 3 years. That means absolutely no voids. And generally, as a rule, with these type of tenancies, generally, but not always, your maintenance costs are minimum because they may be picked up through the housing association as well. Again, something to be aware of. If the tenants move over, you still get paid the rent. Right, so that's a fixed term tenancy through a letting agent. And finally, the last one is a fixed term tenancy agreement directly to you. So you're directly dealing with the local housing association. They've got a contract with you or through a supplier. And that relationship is such that they will pay you every single month for 3 or 5 years a guaranteed rent. This is a completely hands-off, sit back, relax in the Caribbean type strategy. I'm joking, but I'm not joking. Because what this means is your tenants, whether they're there or not, is effectively the British government. Meaning that every single month they pay you. If they have to switch a tenant out or if there's some problem with the property, they deal with it. it gets returned to you minus any basic wear and tear. And that's typical of a contract like this. So a lot of people say, well, is my property going to be wrecked after the 5 years? Actually, the property's looked after, it's maintained, it's their responsibility. And part of that process, it gets back to you. Typically, again, you'll have to check with the contracts you're going to be putting in place, but typically you get that back after the 5 year period, assuming you want it back. In some cases, people say, well, the council might approach you and say, Dr. Rowe, would you be interested in extending this contract out for another 5 years? And you say, well, let me think about that. No voids, guaranteed rent for 5 years. You're going to give it back to me in good condition, you know, all bar the wear and tear. Yes, please, I'll have another 5 years with you. So that's a decision you have to make as an investor. I love it. It's a great strategy. We've been applying it for many years now. Alongside that is government housing, and that has a whole other plethora of different strategies, which I'm not going to talk about right now. So if you're thinking about doing this, remember you're effectively operating as a social housing provider. So you're going to have to go speak to the council. Ideally, you need a little bit of experience in the field already, and that's something that you're going to have to go and speak to the council about to see if they're going to take you on straight away, or whether they might want you to have had a bit more experience and education, a bit more knowledge on how to operate. Because with the social housing, there are some benefits as well, which can include things like grant money. If you know how to go in and qualify for grant money, there's opportunity there for you to take some money in as a grant on the basis that you renovate the property and then you hand it back to them. So again, could be a very good strategy for you. So hopefully that's been useful. It's certainly a strategy that we have been applying for some years, and I'm certainly going to continue to apply because there's such a huge demand for it. To try and put this in perspective, there's over a million and a half people on housing waiting lists right now as I'm recording this video. And in some areas, the waiting lists, i.e. the time it takes for somebody to get into a social housing property, i.e. possibly your property, anything from 10, 15, even 20 years. That's a long time to be waiting. So I think we as responsible landlords can come to the table and hopefully provide some great value to tenants out there that need a home. And we can help out with the social housing list as well. It's Dr. Rowe signing out. Hopefully I'll see you on one of my future tips on investing in property with Dr.